Hey guys, what's going on? Dan here as always. In this video, I'm going to be talking about prototype modeling specifically here. I'm going to be talking about some cars that I've built that are a very special project of mine that I've been trying to do for years, and I've just recently finished. It's a huge story behind it. I mean, not the biggest story, but it's enough that I wanted to go in detail with it to make the whole story understandable, and it's just something I can't do in an update video, so that's why I mentioned in the previous update video, if you've already watched that, that I wasn't going to try to show any of these cars in one of those videos, because there's just too much to talk about. So what I decided to do here is make a separate video just on these cars. That way I can kind of talk about them in detail, and really you guys can get into my mind here, see what I was going for when I made these, hear all the little details and all the little things that make these cars what they are, and how I learned how to do all the weathering techniques on them, and really my kind of an inspirational story, really, of what led me to start prototype modeling in the first place. So it should be an interesting story. I'll try to keep brief here and also show plenty of detail on the cars. Also, you'll notice I'm filming this on my porch, and it's because the lighting in my house is absolutely terrible. I don't have a good way of showing these, so I'm showing them outside here on my porch. It is a sunny day here, so hopefully this will provide enough shade, but still give us enough light that these cars kind of shine out enough. So just kind of bear that in mind if you're wondering the change in scenery. So we're on my porch, that's why. Okay, so anyway, like I said, we'll go ahead and readjust the camera here. I'll get set up on these cars, and we'll go ahead and start talking about it here. Okay, so here we are set up. We're looking at these models now displayed on my little work table here. What these are BFTX C&D gondolas. These are repurposed 62-foot wood chip cars that were originally owned by Apache Railroad. They were patched in the early 2000s for a small company out of New York, BFTX, or Bill Frank Trucking, and they are used to haul C&D, which is construction demolition, basically garbage from New York City, parts of kind of those parts out east, mainly New York City is where these cars were based out of, and they shipped the raw material out west here to Ohio, where they were dumped in a town, Fostoria, Ohio, and Cary, Ohio. So these cars have a lot of history, a lot of interesting graffiti, a lot of interesting weathering, and it's really what inspired me to learn to start weathering and learning how to do graffiti and how to model these, like how to actually be a prototype modeler, was actually seeing these cars for the first time. It's really what inspired me to be where I am today, honestly. I originally saw these cars when I was 10 years old. My dad had actually taken me to Fostoria, Ohio to railfan one time, and up to this point I had never really paid too much attention to graffiti and weathering on the trains that I went by my house on a regular basis, but it wasn't until I stood by the tracks and a trash train came out with these cars on it that I finally noticed the graffiti. I paid attention to how these cars rusted, how the sides were all bent up and beat up. I saw all the patchwork and everything, and I was immediately intrigued, and it's really what inspired me after that point to learn how to weather and how to do all this stuff. So it's these, basically, if you want to say, these cars are what inspired me to learn prototype modeling. And so I began to try to recreate these cars over the years. Keep in mind, I was 10 years old at this time. I'm 23 now, and it's taken me this long to get around to actually building models of these. So there's a lot of good memories attached to them. I had a lot of trial and error in trying to recreate these cars, and I've finally been able to do it using ENC shops with chip cars, which I got a hold of. There's a lot of interesting stories behind how I was able to achieve these, and I'll try to kind of keep it to a short story here. I was able to get a hold of some kits. Up until this point, my weathering skills were not as good as I thought they could be, but I really wanted to make some models of these cars at this point, and I decided it was time, after a lot of practice in weathering and learning how to do graffiti, I decided it was time to try to recreate these. So I basically took the cars, learned how to detail them, scratch build, and add all the various parts to them, and I was able to push myself to get these done over almost a two-year process now, learning how to do all these various weathering effects and stuff that you'll see. So it's a really, really cool project. I'm really happy to do this. There's a lot of good memories attached to these cars. These cars no longer are used anymore. They've been scrapped for a couple years now, but I still remember them, and all that's left now is a couple videos on YouTube of these trains rolling by, or maybe some pictures, but I've been able to recreate them now, and I'm really, really proud to be able to do that. So I want to go ahead and show these cars off now. I'll go ahead and get up close and you guys can view each one of these. Okay, so this is actually the first car I built out of all of these. I have 5 total currently. I plan on building more in the future, but that's another story. So this was the one that I started with, and as I said before, the prototypes are 62-foot roll-end wood chip cars that were used by the Apache Railway, thus the blue paint job. These cars were quickly patched, and new numbers were added, and they proceeded to get used for the C&D service, and they just rusted to hell. They got all kinds of graffiti out of New York City. It's pretty crazy. So as you guys know, the only manufacturer that makes these kinds of cars is ENC Shops, and the kits are less than great, to be honest with you. They leave a lot to be desired. It's a good base for the car. Everything's pretty much accurate, but there's a lot to be desired, like I said. So I began by basically adding all kinds of additional detail parts, like coupler lift bars, new couplers, custom done. Katie doesn't make lower shelf couplers, so I had to modify a pair of double shelf couplers because all these cars use the lower shelf coupler. So I had to modify a pair of KDs for each. I had to put metal wheels on all these. I did full brake underbody detailing, which is something I never thought I'd be doing, but this was another, like I said, these cars are really a method of trying a lot of new techniques and learning how to do underbody piping and everything. It was a real challenge, but again, this one was the real experiment here, so I had to do a lot of work to it. I added all the details. I raised the top cord slightly by adding a styrene strip to the top to raise that, and like I said, full underbody piping, new trucks, new couplers, everything. The next step was to paint them. As you can see, I custom painted the cars. I put all the rust, weathering, and everything on them. All the weathering on these cars is a mixture of acrylics, oils, and powders, all kinds of different things like that. All the graffiti is hand-painted and hand-drawn on there with various various artist pencils, all kinds of different techniques for graffiti here to recreate all this. The first car here is BFTX 1562. The other issue with these models is that no decals exist for this particular car. So a friend of mine, Matt Ferrillo out of Colorado, was gracious enough to assist me in this project by not only supplying some models, but also a great resource for prototype photos and custom-made decals, which is extremely appreciative. So he supplied me with all the data and all the little patches that these cars have, and then another modeler, Charles E. Davis, supplied me with the custom BFTX patches that I put on the ends and the sides here. All the numbers, everything else, all the additional data is done with microscale decals. So from the side shot here, you guys can get a good look at all the custom painted graffiti and everything that was done to this. This car has a lot of unique graffiti, and again, all of these artists are out of New York. It's a lot of interesting urban artwork here that I had to learn to recreate here as carefully as I could. And again, this is all acrylic, pencils, all kinds of different techniques to create the graffiti here. And again, you can see all the really, really fine details, all the rust spots, the heavy weathering. It's a really unique weathering. I've never attempted any of this before, but it was a very, very big pain in the ass because all this had to be painted by hand. There's no quick and easy way of doing this, so all the rust spots had to be painted in by hand, all the streaks and everything had to be added. Again, all the patches are done from prototype photos. Each car is carefully done to prototype photos. They're probably the most accurate cars I own in terms of prototype details and everything. And again, full underbody details, you can kind of see that under there. Full brake piping and everything. The custom reporting marks are added. Again, those are custom decals made by Charles E. Davis. Thanks for... The second car I did here was BFTX 1583, and as you can see, this one's similar to the first one, 1562. All these cars didn't look too different between each other. They all had some subtle variations in patching and stuff like that. The graffiti was all different, but other than that, they're pretty much the same car. So again, upgraded details, custom patching, all the graffiti is hand-painted, of course. And you can really see all that nice weathering effect, or weathering effects, rather. All the accurate graffiti, and then the custom decals there. Really nice. And then here's a good shot of the custom Bill Frank, the decal there that these cars were labeled with, the ownership mark. Again, that's a custom decal. Really nice. I'm really glad I got a hold of those. Without these cars wouldn't look right, so that's an important effect, or an important decal to have on these cars. Again, you can see all the really nice truck weathering, underbody detailing, etc.